I thought I'd, you know, have a little bit of room to go. I'm going to, since it did sound like an introduction, what I'll do is give you a little bit of a taste here before I bring up Joan Job Smith. This mentions Bungalow 3K7, UCLA. That was where we watched all these Christopher the Mill films, and Morrison, of course, made his student film there, and that was a controversy all in itself. This is my tribute, actually, to those years. And up until the end of the 1970s, a set of film department bungalows, editing rooms in there on the UCLA campus, where I'd once in a while watch Ray and Jim rolling celluloid through these through this movieola, the old technology, the old-fashioned way to cut film with a razor blade, right? So every Friday afternoon, we would attend this film survey class, and movie industry people would arrive, and we would witness and analyze and criticize some of the most awful movies I've ever watched. And some of us would turn into critics and sardonically bark wit, bitter glitter in our eyes. We would dissect these movies, many of which we felt was this Hollywood hokum and baloney. The screening room was called Bungalow 3K7, and so is this. To Manzarek, long after Bungalow 3K7. Nativities, pop music syndrome, cinema. Student films that train consumers, technical clones become deaf to irradiated scream. An eclectic electric saccharin pours over an imitation of Christmas earth in order to sweeten the dietetic terror of our time. I have no right to construe terror. Box office is jury box. The audience is an idolatry of amplified faces. My own cry is a crown of secret hair. See how it hangs down on the popular ground. You know how they impersonate the tangled crucifixion of my hair, the same way hysterical groupies and cops impersonate a theater of war. Winter white, freezing backstage passes for those two snowbirds, for sacrifice, for sympathy. See how they become twins to my own humanity. The Bone Daddies, everybody. Yeah. Joan Job Smith would tell you the story.